Hello, this is Connie Belden, and in this video, we're going to talk about what to do when an account receivable goes bad. In other words, a customer doesn't end up paying you the money they owe you. And then we're also going to take a look at when a customer might want to extend their account receivable to a notes receivable. And in that case, then if they extend it to a notes receivable, we can start charging them interest, also known as interest revenue. But first of all, let's talk about what to do about uncollectible account receivable. Well, there are two different methods you can use. One is the allowance method. One is the direct write-off method. Most commonly used would be the allowance method. This is kind of a summary chart of both methods, and I'll scroll down and look at some specific illustrations. Let's start with the allowance method. First of all, in the allowance method, the company estimates in advance how much they expect not to collect, how much of their sales on account receivable they expect customers will never pay. Usually it's a percentage of their total sales, but let's say in this case we've estimated that 3,000 of our accounts receivable will probably not be collected. So therefore, with the allowance method, we go ahead and immediately set it up as a bad debt expense. That will show up as an expense on the income statement. And we're going to credit allowance for doubtful accounts. That's going to be a new account that will appear with the current assets. Now, let's take a look at how that will appear on the balance sheet. That allowance for doubtful accounts is going to reduce the balance of account receivable. So therefore, you would list it with your current assets. So you would probably still have cash, account receivable. Let's assume that balance is 20,000. But you expect to not collect 3,000 of that. So therefore, below it, you will say less allowance for doubtful accounts. And you will subtract, not add. And in the middle column, put 17,000. So what that is doing is giving you a more accurate balance of what you expect your assets to be, because you really expect 17,000 to be collected, not the entire 20. So that way it doesn't overstate your assets. And then your other assets such as supplies, and then you can total your current assets, just like you've done before. This allowance for doubtful accounts, your notice is credited. It normally has a credit balance. And notice that it is a subtraction with your assets. So we do call it a contra asset. The reason why, it is listed with the assets, but it normally has a credit balance, whereas assets normally have a debit balance. And again, it's subtracted away from account receivable. So this works similar to the way that we subtracted accumulated depreciation from equipment. Look at it that way. Okay, once you're sure a customer's not going to pay you, maybe it's a period of time, or maybe they went out of business, then you can actually write it off. So remember, we estimated 3,000 would go bad. Now we're assuming Mr. Brown is not going to pay us. We're pretty certain that $200. So we are going to write off that $200. So we're debit allowance for doubtful accounts. And by the way, that would leave a $2,800 balance in allowance for doubtful accounts that you still expect to go bad. And that's when you're actually credit account receivable and take it out of account receivable. Notice that in this first initial setup journal entry, as I call it, we did not debit or credit account receivable. Now, if Mr. Brown never pays it, you're done. But what happens if Mr. Brown feels guilty and he decides to pay you that $200? Well, remember, you wrote it off against account receivable. So you're going to have to reverse this entry right here by debiting account receivable and crediting allowance for doubtful accounts. Then you'll write a second entry that debits cash because you received cash and credit account receivable because he paid it off. So yes, that entry involves both a debit and a credit to account receivable, but you have to do that because you have to put it back into account receivable before you can show it being paid off. Okay, next, let's look at the direct write-off method. Couple of things to remember about this. First of all, it does not use the allowance for doubtful accounts. Second of all, it doesn't set up any estimated amount, therefore, that you expect to go bad. So what you do is you record it at the time it goes bad. So, for example, let's assume Mr. Brown did not pay us our $200. So, notice that here we debited allowance for doubtful accounts. In the direct write-off method, because there was no setup, no allowance account, we debit bad debt expense. But notice that we credited account receivable up here. We still credit account receivable in the direct write-off method. Now, same situation. If Mr. Brown does end up paying us, we would have to reverse this previous entry by debiting account receivable and crediting bad debt expense. So we're just reversing this entry right here, and then show the payment of cash. Okay, so that is how we handle bad account receivable. I'm going to stop the video at this point, and on the next video, we will talk about notes receivable. Thank you very much.